Hey, Matt.
What's up?
You know what's inside?
What's inside?
Intel.
God damn it. Hello and welcome to This Is. The GPU market has a ray of sunshine in front of it because we have a savior in the market, and it's Intel.
So Intel has been making graphics for a very long time, right? They've had their integrated graphics, which have been bad to mildly okay to fairly decent these days. And the fruits of that labor are about to be upon us, friends. So take your Scalp 3090s and throw them in the trash. Take your RTX 9000 series that's coming out soon and forget about it.
Or maybe don't do that because you guys all did that with your 20 series and then no one had GPUs for a while because they're like, oh, I'm going to sell my 20, I'm going to sell my 2080 because I'm going to get a 3090.
That was the way it was for so long, Matt. And then
no one had GPUs forever.
So what Intel is doing here is essentially, at least from what we know, scaling up in a fairly big way their existing graphics architecture, right? So obviously it will be different. It's not like they're just taking the integrated graphics from a laptop and, you know, doubling it and turning up clock speeds. Yeah. They're working on the first generation of their Arc GPUs, which will be launching this year.
I have doubts about that.
You don't think it's coming out this year?
Or
you think it's going to be bad?
So originally what it was supposed to be, the roadmap was, what they announced in August, was Q1 for notebook GPUs.
Yep.
Q2 for desktop, Q3 for workstation.
Yes.
I don't think they're going to hit that. And I think they're just going to be delayed in general. Best case scenario, we maybe get Q4. Because we've seen nothing. The only thing we've seen is them showing it off with a game from 2018. They showed it off with Tomb Raider. So, like, you know, the fact that we have no specs, we have no nothing. And I think it's more realistic that it's going to be kind of next year that we start to see things really roll out.
This is a very difficult task to bring a brand new GPU to the market. Mm-hmm. I mean, this is difficult for AMD and NVIDIA, and they've had decades of experience with this. And mind you, Intel's not coming into this completely blind. They have been creating graphics, so that has given them a huge leg up. But going from integrated graphics on a laptop compared to dedicated GPUs is a very big stretch. They started this work in earnest a few years ago, and we're really just starting to see what's coming out. So I think we have to have a little bit of a tempered expectation. First and foremost, they're going to take multiple generations to truly catch up. We're not going to see an Intel GPU this year, which is going to go blow away the RTX 3090 and the RX 6950 XT. It's not going to happen. I think what we will see is laptop GPU shipping, which will be mid-range and fine. There will almost certainly be some issues, whether they are not super competitive on like power or performance or price. Like, I'm sure they're not going to completely nail it right out of the box, but I'm sure it will be okay this year. They also will have GPUs for desktops at some point, probably later in the year. I agree. I think they're maybe not going to hit that Q2 timeframe, but I do think you'll be able to buy an Intel dedicated GPU, slap it in your system, and based on a lot of the rumors, you're going to be getting mid-range performance. So think something like maybe a 3060 or a 6600 XT or something like that. Like, it's hard to say exactly where it's going to be, but like
now,
decent mid-range, I think, is what I expect for this year with this first generation of Intel.
It's tough because I want this to happen so bad because another, you know, competitor in the GPU market is great for the consumer.
Yes.
You know, it's been NVIDIA and AMD for so long.
Yeah.
You know,
it's going to spice things up.
It's going to spice things up. It's okay if they're not amazing right out the gate.
Sure.
But they have to be good enough for a handful of people to catch on. Because if they suck out the gate, it's gonna be impossible for them to get traction.
There's a few ways they can handle that, though. Number one, they could have enough of these things to just put on store shelves at MSRP. Yeah. That by itself, even if they are sort of mid-range-ish GPUs,
would be a huge, huge advantage for them if they actually could say, we can keep these in stock.
Yeah, I'm a firm believer, especially in the PC market. Most products, if they have a good price, will make sense, right? A GPU, even if it's super power inefficient, if it's at the right price, it will make sense for some people. They also, I think one of the interesting things is they have a roadmap. So they pretty much already said in their roadmap that this first generation is not going to be amazing, right? They're targeting Gen 2 and even Gen 3 before they're able to go for, what do they call it, the ultra enthusiast segment, which, aka like 3090. Yeah, you know,
people are comparing to 3090, 3090 Ti, whatever. But I think it's actually going to be compared to
the 5090.
6090. Yeah, like exactly. Like, I don't know. Like, I want this to succeed because, again, I want there to be more options out there. Because just having the two companies right now, it's worked, but
AMD recently just brought out that new GPU, and everyone was just absolutely roasting it because it is by all intents and purposes, weak and slow and terrible. But because there's no competition and no one can get cheap GPUs on the market, it's still worth it. It's still a product that is selling, even though it shouldn't, because it's
agreed. Here's the problem that they're gonna, that Intel's gonna run into, is everything still comes from TSMC.
And that's one of the big differences with this project, because Intel is actually not creating the GPU. They're designing it, but they're sending it to TSMC to be manufactured.
Do you think that they can leverage all of their Intel chips as a way to say, like, oh, we're going to jump the line a little bit?
No.
It's the same way that, because that's what Apple does.
Yeah, but Apple is years and they're paying way more. I think Intel is getting in line and they're going to get just as many GPUs off the line as AMD or anyone else can. Probably less, because AMD has the track record and probably ordering way more. Even with this sort of early generation of Intel chips, it will help. These GPUs will hit the market. But I mean, by some estimates, this is going to be maybe like an additional 10% GPU supply for the year, which is not nothing. It's going to help. But 10%, we need way more than 10% more GPUs to be able to catch up and to really sort of make sure that these things are on shelves at MSRP the way that they were back in, you know, 2018, 2019. So I think this almost, I want to say it's a drop in the bucket, because it is an important first step. And it will be, I think, if they get the price right, a good product for a lot of people. But this is not the cure to the GPU shortages that we're seeing in the market. I almost think that what is going to tell the story of 2022 for graphics cards, and if you can actually get your hands on one for less than an arm and or a kidney, is going to be the fact of crypto prices staying low, more so than Intel. Because you know that the first product is never going to be great, but if it is okay, they can actually keep it on shelves and the price is reasonable, this will be a success. And they already have Generation 2 and Generation 3 on the way, right? Like, they are well into, like, Generation 2 is probably already done. Like, they're probably working on Generation 3 of kind of like finalizing the design and stuff, which is going to come out in 2024, 2025. But the thing is, this is a long-term project. You can't judge Intel's GPU by the very first thing they come out. Obviously, you can make the decision to buy or not, and of course we all will. I'm sure we'll talk more about it once we actually get our hands on it. But the thing is, this is the first step. It is an important step with the way that the market is right now, because it is, every GPU that hits the market is only a good thing for gamers and for people who want to build PCs. But you got to think the long game on this. And if this is okay, Generation 2 will probably be pretty good. Generation 3 might be great. We'll have to see. But there's no scenario in which this is going to be a bad thing for gamers. Because the more choice we have, the more competition, when Intel and AMD actually have to fight not only just each other and going just, you know, back and forth, but they actually have to consider, oh, Intel's going to come in and undercut us, or they're going to have some crazy new thing or whatever the case
is. And that's why I think they have, this has to be at least okay. Like, it cannot be trash. That's really, like, if it is trash,
game over.
Gamers write it off. Consumers are very quick to judgment. Of like, if it's, something's not amazing out the gate, it hardly ever catches on. When AMD bought ATI in the Radeon cards, no one wanted to buy those. They wanted to just get the NVIDIA cards, because those were perceived better.
Yeah,
and we're just now seeing people being like, okay, the AMD cards are viable. But it's still,
there's a stigma. Like, there's a stigma.
It's hard to get around that. No one's first choice is an AMD card. You know, we get in our DMs constantly, oh, can I please have a free PC? And not only do I say, can I have a free PC?
With an RTX 3090?
They specify the specs of what they want. I have never once seen someone say, can I get a free PC with an AMD card?
I guess that is a good point.
If someone is picking and choosing, like, I'm not saying AMD cards are bad. I have an AMD card. It's great.
Yeah.
But most people, if given the choice, prefer to go with an NVIDIA card.
Yeah.
And it's about perception. These battles are not fought on shelves. They're fought in, like, Reddit subreddits and things like that. Or if someone's like, oh yeah, I got the new Intel card, and you know, maybe the specs on paper aren't as good as
it's $180 and I was able to find it on a store shelf.
Right. I was able to get it. I took a chance on it, and I was able to play my games at, you know, on this first generation, I was able to play at 60 FPS locked at medium. Those types of Reddit posts and stuff like that, that's where these cards win these battles.
Yeah.
But if it's like, oh yeah, I took a chance on this thing, I'm at low settings and barely getting 40 FPS or whatever, all it takes is one of those posts for no one to ever want to buy that again.
Yeah.
So as long as Intel comes out with something that is decent,
yes,
I think they have a really good shot, and I think that's really good for consumers.
Decent and aggressively priced. I think those are my two benchmarks for what's going to happen. Laptops are going to be one thing. Obviously, those get bundled, blah, blah, blah. Like, we'll see how that goes.
Yeah.
But when they actually have the desktop GPUs coming out at some point this year, I'm going to be super interested to see the performance level versus the price level that they are targeting. If they get it right, I think it could be a big, big win. But there's a lot of ways that they could get that wrong. But let us know what you think in the comments below. Make sure to like, subscribe, ring-a-ling the ding-a-ling button, and pre-order our brand new This Is GPUs, which are promised to be 17 times better and 45 times cheaper. Just PayPal Matt your life savings, and I'm sure it'll be available.
All $6 of it.
Can I say, actually, you know what? I don't think I can say that. I think that's actually going to get me in trouble.
Yeah, especially because I feel like that's something that Linus would actually do. Is Linus, to make a Linus GPU.
LTTstore.com/GPU.